Let's go to Trinity College, right?
Get out of here. Okay.
You know, if everyone in the server went to Trinity College, the server would be a better place.
You know, actually, hold on. Could you host Trinity College? So everyone, we could all be trains.
Could I host it?
Together. Yes,
like,
host
Trinity
College.
Am I like a trained professor?
Yeah, dude.
That could teach my trained underlings?
Yeah, dude. Stop it with the Rick and Morty jokes. Those
okay,
are
if you make a Rick and Morty joke, I will never read anything you put in chat again. So I've read my book about trains and whatnot for the 10,000th time now. And I feel like if people here would be reciprocal, I could host a class in train college.
Okay, I'd like...
Right here, right now.
Okay.
If you'd like to go to train college, Dayton, at this very server, push one in chat. I am now your training teacher, if I wasn't already.
Oh! Okay, right. I'm sorry, but self-defense.
So for my first lesson in train college, or should I say, train server college, I would like to go back way back when I first went to train college, and I'm going to teach you what I learned on my first day. See, the thing that was so magical to me when I first went to college, train college that is that when I went there, there was only 5 other people in the class with me. Alright, I'm not very comfortable sharing my my own life experiences, but I'm a teacher now, so I'm gonna give you some of the most important lessons about trains. Train college is very expensive, and I myself have spent millions of dollars. And if you too would like to go to train college...
Hold on. I'll be back.
You're going to have to give me money?
I need to rob someone.
Alright, you do that.
I only have 999,999
dollars. Put your hands behind your back. Get that wall. Go up against that wall. I'm robbing you.
So your semester has now been paid for. Train college can now begin.
Oh man, I'm excited.
So on your first day of train college, we won't be learning about different kinds of trains or anything generally in the technical of trains. In fact, on day one, we're going to learn how to appreciate trains and in the different forms trains take.
I can't
hear
you.
So by now, you should all very much love trains.
If you don't love trains,
please exit the classroom, because this is a train lovers only. See, the thing about trains with me, it isn't just that I have been learning about trains in my 80 years of existence. From the day I was born, what really got me into trains was that my entire family, all of their lives were saved by trains. In fact, my grandfather, my great-grandfather, my great-great-grandfather, my great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandfather, reaching back all the way to the dawn of time, every single one of their lives were saved by trains. So in the first day of train college, we have to learn to appreciate why we like trains so much. In order to fully appreciate our next...
I like trains because they make a funny toot-toot noise when they're going around. And they're just really cool.
Are you patronizing me? You think this is a fucking joke?
Wait, what?
Toot-toot?
No, you get out.
I don't think it's the class for you, alright?
This is the class for me, okay? Trust me.
Fucking toot-toot?
You're just dumb.
Like, I don't want any toot-toot in my class, alright?
Okay,
you can take that shit outside.
It's toot-toot. It's toot-toot. Toot-toot.
All right. You can stay for now.
Okay.
One more time, and you're out of here.
Okay, then.
I can't expect you to write the essay now. You don't know enough about trains. After I'm done, you're going to know all you need to know about trains for this 100-word essay. Just, look through my book here. Alright, hold on. Flipping through my book. Alright. So after reading the book, The Great Book Gods of Train Book. Alright, class. Can anyone get that's what I just read? This will be on the test.
You read about, I don't know.
I read about trains.
Oh.
Are you an idiot?
I thought you meant...
You don't deserve to be in my class.
I thought you meant something, like, specific about
Get
trains.
Get out!
No.
No, I've had enough. I told you that was your last strike. You're out.
I'm shooting you down right now.
Fucking train college. You don't even know what you're doing. Get over here.
You go back to train elementary.
You're evicted.
I'm teaching this class
right now.
College
for you?
I'm teaching this class.
I have real students to teach you. Do we change classrooms? Where do you want to go? Alright, field trip. Field trip, pick up your stuff. Let's go field trip. Field trip, boys.
Trains are stupid.
Alright, this looks like a good spot for school. There. Babe. So I'm gonna start my speech. You have 10 seconds to get to class or you're disqualified. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 9. Baden is now officially evicted from my school.
I don't care, trains are dumb.
I'm glad that guy's out of here. He doesn't even like fucking trains. Now I'm gonna read a speech, not by me.
5.
By one of the other great minds of the train community. This person has contributed literally everything you'll ever learn about trains in the train handbook. The creator of the book itself. This is the man's speech I'm about to read.
Oh, yeah.
Alright, hold on. I'm also trying to memorize it as I'm reading it. Because you're not the only one learning here, alright? Alright, but the most complicated thing about this speech is that it's not even written in English. It's actually written in a language only used by trains. So some of the translations won't quite be there. But I'm gonna try anyway. Chapter 1. The Creation of Train Existence. So in the beginning, there were three trains. These three trains created the universe. Not in a big explosion or bang or any other means that might be imagined by humans. These trains created the universe through an entirely new method. Using all three trains, they combined, and through their existence combined, they spread their own matter throughout the universe, and this is where we currently reside. Everything around us is not atoms or any other thing people like to call it. We are in fact all children of trains. We are the...
I'm leaving this conga line, everyone. Follow me.
I had to remove that ruffian from my classroom.
Yeah, what?
So in a way, when I say that humans are different from... They spread throughout the galaxy. and they made the first mistake of any and all trains. They, of course, separated. They left their combined ship, train ship, and kind of did their own thing. And in this way, it made trains very distant from themselves.
Honk, honk. We're gonna Mario Kart.
In fact, it almost made trains, future generations of trains, solitary creatures. Not quite social animals. Are social beings. They prefer to be alone, just like their ancestors did when they split up. There's a lesson in this.
The lesson being, guys, I don't think you guys are getting sick.
You should never split up with your friends you've created the universe with. That is your first lesson and end of chapter one.
No, dang it.
If you have any questions, please post them in chat about that chapter. You are here to learn. If you have anything you don't understand, I need to know. If you don't understand something, you don't tell me. You can get the hell out of here. Why do some people think trains are dumb? If you meet somebody who thinks that trains are dumb,
because they steal $3
million
from
you. They are in fact the most idiotic
you?
Person in the world and don't deserve to live.
They steal $3 million from you. Yeah.